Chapter 11, Fluoride in the Drinking Water. German Nazi chemists worked out a very ingenious and far-reaching plan of mass control that was submitted to and adopted by the German General Staff. This plan was to control the population of any given area through mass medication of drinking water supplies. The real reason behind water fluoridation is not to benefit children's teeth. The real purpose behind water fluoridation is to reduce the resistance of the masses to domination and control and loss of liberty. Repeated doses of infinitesimal amounts of fluorine will in time gradually reduce the individual's power to resist domination by slowly poisoning and narcotizing this area of brain tissue and make him submissive to the will of those who wish to govern him. Any person who drinks artificially fluoridated water for a period of 1 year or more will never again be the same person, mentally or physically. This is a quote by Charles Elliot Perkins, U.S. chemist sent to reconstruct the Nazi IG Farben chemical empire after World War II. Fluoride is described as any binary compound of fluorine. Fluorine is described as a poisonous yellow gaseous element of the halogen group. This situation cannot be ignored because water is essential for our existence, considering that the majority of our body is made up of it. We have been convinced that fluoride, rat poison, will save our teeth, and Americans drink more fluoridated water than any other nation on earth, but is also used in public water supplies by 11 countries. The former head of the Harvard School of Dental Medicine, James M. Dunning, stated that the big cities in the U.S. were mostly fluoridated by executive action in such a way as to avoid public referenda. Fluoride is essentially a poison that accumulates in the bones. It has been associated with cancer in young males, osteoporosis, reduced IQ and hip fractures in the elderly. There has been a sordid 50-year promotion of fluoridation by the U.S. Department of Public Health and the American Dental Association, rather than acknowledge the evidence which has gathered of the effect of fluoride to a person's health. They put themselves into a position with tactics including the harassment of scientists and dentists that dare to speak out. During World War II, the Nazis experimented with new technology in nuclear science, energy manipulation, psychoactive drugs, and propaganda and mind control. They studied the best way to dumb down a nation's population, and one of the chemicals used was fluoride. Fluoride is a key ingredient in Prozac and many other psychotropic drugs. Prozac has a scientific name of fluoxetine and is 94% fluoride. This is a quote by Jim Mars, author and medical writer Mary Sperodenser, noted that since the 1930s, Austrian and German scientists were treating overacting thyroids by bathing people in fluoride. It became effective because fluoride blocked thyroid function. In 2013, 70% of the United States was forced to receive the thyroid-blocking chemical via their water without their consent. This is a crime according to the Nuremberg Code of Ethics because the consent of a person is absolutely essential. Fluoridation of our community water systems can well become their most subtle weapon for our sure physical and mental deterioration. As a research chemist of established standing, I built within the past 22 years, 3 American chemical plants and licensed 6 of my 53 patents. Based on my years of practical experience in the health food and chemical field, let me warn. Fluoridation of drinking water is criminal insanity, sure national suicide. Don't do it, even in very small quantities. Sodium fluoride is a deadly poison to which no effective antidote has been found. Every exterminator knows that it is the most effective rat killer. Sodium fluoride water solutions are the cheapest and most effective rat killers known to chemists, colorless, odorless, tasteless, no antidote, no remedy, no hope. This is a quote by Dr. E. H. Bronner, chemist. James Donahue at viewzone.com writes that he was a child in the United States when fluoride was introduced. Nobody told us where fluoride came from. All we knew is that it was a newly discovered chemical that would make our teeth extra hard and ward off cavities. When a free fluoride clinic was set up one summer in our school, all the kids in town lined up to have the bitter tasting stuff rubbed on their teeth. People were lulled into the belief that men in white lab jackets could solve all the problems of the world. The belief was so strong that we blindly accepted whatever a scientist told us. Nobody ever dreamed that we might be victims of fraud. Dr. John Yiamouyanis wrote a book entitled Fluoride, The Aging Factor, and in it he shows that the drug causes a premature aging process, and he notes that in areas where fluoride is consumed in the drinking water, there are higher rates of bone disorders and people suffer from brown decaying teeth. People were lulled into the belief that men in white lab jackets could solve all the problems of the world. The belief was so strong that we blindly accepted whatever a scientist told us. Nobody ever dreamed that we might be victims of fraud. Dr. John Yiamouyanis wrote a book entitled Fluoride, The Aging Factor, and in it he shows that the drug causes a premature aging process, and he notes that in areas where fluoride is consumed in the drinking water, there are higher rates of bone disorders and people suffer from brown decaying teeth. The 1984 issue of Clinical Toxicology of Commercial Products lists fluoride as more poisonous than lead and just slightly less poisonous than arsenic. It has been used as a pesticide for mice, rats and other small pests. A 10-pound infant could be killed by one stroke 100 of an ounce, and a 100-pound adult could be killed by one stroke 10 of an ounce of fluoride. The acceleration of the aging process by fluoride occurs at the biochemical level by causing enzyme inhibition, collagen breakdown, genetic damage and disruption of the immune system. Researcher Michael White said that when fluoride gets into your bones, it stays there for years and there is no established treatment for skeletal fluorosis. No one knows if you can fully recover from it. There is evidence that the program of water fluoridization started in an effort to cover up bad publicity from one of the most toxic materials emerging from the U.S. government's secret Manhattan Project, the atomic bomb-making program. Reporters Joel Griffiths and Chris Bryson discovered the truth about fluoride while examining declassified documents about this project. They found that millions of tons were used during the Cold War period to manufacture uranium and plutonium. Fluoride was the top chemical hazard of the U.S. nuclear weapons program, not only for workers, but for those living nearby as well. Documents show that the first U.S. lawsuits levied against the atomic weapons program were over fluoride poisoning, not radiation damage. Documents reveal that the U.S. government secretly ordered atomic bomb scientists to create evidence useful in litigation against defense contractors who were being accused of injuring citizens with fluoride. Therefore, there is also poison in most commercial brands of toothpaste, so if you use them, you are more than likely brushing your teeth with toxic waste, supporting the big corporations that ultimately control the world's governments. Remember that corporations that we don't support eventually dry up and we never see them again. In 1999, the U.S. Environmental Protection Agency stated about fluoridization that our opposition to drinking water fluoridization has grown, based on the scientific literature documenting the increasingly out-of-control exposures to fluoride, the lack of benefit to dental health from ingestion of fluoride and the hazards to human health from such ingestion. These hazards include acute toxic hazards such as to people with impaired kidney function, as well as chronic toxic hazards of gene mutations, cancer, reproductive effects, neurotoxicity, bone pathology and dental fluorosis. In support of this concern are results from two epidemiology studies from China that show decreases in IQ in children who got more fluoride than the control groups of children in each study. These decreases are about 5 to 10 IQ points in children aged 8 to 13 years. Other effects of fluoride include the calcification of the pineal gland. The pineal gland unlocks spiritual awareness and intuition. This is only one small piece of the jigsaw of the elite agenda to keep us in our pens and treated as farm animals. The EPA fired the Office of Drinking Water's chief toxicologist, Dr. William Marcus, for refusing to remain silent on the cancer risk issues. Dr. Cahoon, a former principal dental officer for Auckland in New Zealand, was a staunch supporter of fluoridization until he was given the task of looking at the worldwide data of fluoridization's effectiveness in preventing tooth cavities. In his paper, he provides details on how data was manipulated to support fluoridization in English-speaking countries, especially the US and New Zealand. Mutation studies show that fluoride can cause gene mutations in mammalian and lower order tissues at fluoride concentrations estimated to be present in the mouth from fluoridated toothpastes. Further, there were tumors of the oral cavity seen in the NTP cancer study, further strengthening concern over the toxicity of topically applied fluoride. For governmental and other organizations to continue to push for more exposure in the face of current levels of overexposure coupled with an increasing crescendo of adverse toxicity findings is irrational and irresponsible at best. Recent peer-reviewed toxicity data, when applied to the EPA's standard method for controlling risks from toxic chemicals, require an immediate halt to the use of the nation's drinking water reservoirs as disposal sites for the toxic waste of the phosphate fertilizer industry. According to Dr. Dean Burke, PhD, who worked for 34 years at the National Cancer Institute, in point of fact, fluoride causes more human cancer death and causes it faster than any other chemical. Sodium fluoride, sodium silica fluoride and hydrofluorosilicic acid are all used in dental offices, toothpaste and water practices. These are toxic waste substances created from the creation process in the fertilizer, steel, nuclear and aluminium industries. Dean Burke was an American biochemist who co-discovered biotin, a chemical necessary for cell growth, the production of fatty acids and the metabolism of fats and amino acids. He was the head chief chemist at the National Cancer Institute. He is quoted as saying, "In point of fact, fluoride causes more human cancer deaths than any other chemical. They, National Cancer Institute, lie like scoundrels. When you have power, you don't have to tell the truth. That's a rule that's been working in this world for generations, and there are a great many people who don't tell the truth when they are in power in administrative positions. Fluoride amounts to murder on a grand scale." In 1954, a Christian Science Monitor survey showed that 79 out of 81 Nobel Prize winners in chemistry, physiology and medicine refused to endorse water fluoridation, but every U.S. Public Health Service general since then has supported putting it into the water supply. Amazing. Did you know that in 2013 and 2014, the city of Sacramento performed an experiment with water treatment at the expense of its residents, supposedly in order to save money? Obviously, the residents were never informed, and city officials allowed the experiment to continue for a whole year, despite knowing that the process was creating carcinogens. Cancer, miscarriages and birth defects are the consequences of consuming the chemicals. Officials experimented with a new chemical added to the water to aid in the removing of sediment, silt and other impurities. The chemical was aluminium chlorohydrate. Ash. It was due to replace the chemical known as Asylum that was used to take the larger particles out of the river water to treat it. Both of these chemicals weigh down the sediment to make it removable. The addition of ash wound up being ineffective, so an excessive amount of chlorine was added as well. The combination of excess chlorine and aluminium chlorohydrate created carcinogenic toxins known as DBPs, which are disinfection byproducts. These are in the same class of chemicals known as THMs. THMs are in the same chemical class as chloroform, according to water research. The THMs remained in the water supply for a year after the experiment ended. In March 2014, readings were way up across the city. Some people were drinking water with DBP levels above 130 parts per billion. Sacramento's utility director, Bill Buseth, told ABC 10 News that there was an expectation that we would be able to save quite a bit of money. Bob Bocock worked in the water industry and he said this community was basically looked at as a lab guinea pig, in that they were exposed to violation level trihalomethanes for up to 1 year without any proper notification. According to a June article in the Sacramento Bee, water from 6 out of 11 wells in the Rio Linda Alberta district tested above the state's maximum contaminant levels for chromium-6. Wells closest to the former McClellan Air Force Base have the highest levels of hexavalent chromium or chromium-6, a known carcinogen. Exposure to chromium-6 can lead to skin irritation, asthma and kidney and liver damage, according to the National Institute for Occupational Safety and Health. A Rio Linda resident named Anna Marie Tomlinson hadn't touched her tap water in years because she was the fourth person on her block to get cancer, and said that I drank it every day. I know the water gave me cancer, she commented. William Cooper tells the tale in Behold the Pale Horse, written in 1991, that in the state of Colorado and in other states, dioxin was turning up in the drinking water in alarming levels, and he said that it should not be present in any amount at all. Dioxin is one of the deadliest chemicals known to man. He said in his book that Colorado citizens attempting to do battle against the dioxin contamination were met with closed doors, denial and attacks upon their characters. What a surprise. According to author Jim Mars, an executive order was signed in March 2012 by President Obama. Under Section 201(5), National Defense Resources Preparedness Order, NDRPO, the Secretary of Defense will be in charge of water resources. Why, I ask? Defense has nothing to do with the water that is consumed by a nation's people, unless there are other motives at work, which of course there are. According to NDRPO, virtually everything in the U.S. will come under the total control of the National Security Council and Homeland Security in conjunction with the National Economic Council, all of which will serve the president. This is one part of the totalitarian tiptoe towards the police state that is coming already here. More about that later.